Hello and welcome. In this Node-RED video, we will take a look at HTTP GET and its uses in Node-RED. Some of you might know HTTP GET as URL API. It is powerful yet simple tool used in IoT to control your smart devices. I will demonstrate URL API today by switching on and off the output of the power socket. I will be using this NETIO PowerCable REST smart power socket and a simple LED light to demonstrate output state changes. Due to its open API and real-time metering, PowerCable REST can be used in all Node-RED projects you can think of. NETIO offers wide variety of smart power sockets. It is safe to say that you will find what you need for your project. And now, let's take a look at the Node-RED flow. This is how my flow looks like. You can find it in NETIO application node AN29. The link is in the description. AN29 is Node-RED guide for beginners in Node-RED explaining URL API and Node-RED basics. If you are starting with Node-RED, then I can't recommend it enough. The whole flow, node by node, is described in detail in AN29. And this is my dashboard. As you can see, it's combined from 5 buttons. Each sends different URL API requests in order to control your NETIO smart power socket, and text node, which displays responses from your device to URL API requests. You can easily control your smart power socket from Node-RED dashboard. After pressing the button, the HTTP GET request is sent and device is switched. And now, let's have a look how it works in practice. It is that easy. You can control almost anything with URL API. Your heating system, restaurant freezer, or lights. It doesn't matter what. NETIO smart power sockets with open API can control almost anything. And if we add Node-RED to the mix, then the applications are limitless. That's all for today. I hope you liked this video. If yes, then please share it. And as I said earlier, you can find all you need to start your first Node-RED project in NETIO AN29. The link is in the description along with the link to use NETIO smart power socket.